SchoolFreeware's free Pascal program tutorials. Tutorial 10, Input Validation. Input validation checks user input to make sure that correct information has been entered into the program. This video will show simple input validation using the repeat until loop. The next video in this series will show how to prevent the program from crashing when incorrect data types are entered into the program. The examples used within this tutorial use AND or logical operators. When the AND logical operator is used, all AND conditions must be met for the entire condition to be true. With the OR logical operator, at least one OR condition must be met for the entire condition to be true. The code used within this tutorial can be downloaded at schoolfreeware.com. A new program has already been created. The code to make the computer stop has already been put within the program. The first example will ask the user to enter in A or B, and then check to see if the user has entered in A or B. So I'm going to put in a variable, make the variable name cell, short for selection. Cell is going to be a character data type. I'll write to the screen, prompting the user to make a selection, A or B. Then I'll read line the input into cell. I'll go make a simple little case statement here. Case cell of, in this particular case, we'll have uppercase A and lowercase a. We'll begin, and I'll write line A was selected. I'll end for A, and I'll make the other possibility, B, uppercase B, lowercase b, will begin. And I'll write line, B was selected. Okay, there's our simple little program. Go ahead, run, test this out. If I put in an A, we have A is selected. If I put in B, B was selected, but I want to prevent somebody from putting in something else, like a D, which the computer will return nothing. So I want to make sure that the user has entered either an A or a B. So what I'm going to do is make a repeat until loop. So we'll repeat these two lines, and I'll just go ahead and indent them, so it makes it a little bit easier to read. We'll repeat until cell equals uppercase A or cell equals lowercase a or cell equals uppercase B or cell equals lowercase b. So with this type of statement, all we need to have is an uppercase A or a lowercase a or an uppercase B or a lowercase b entered into the computer, and this loop will then stop. So when I go ahead and run now, if I entered in something other than A or B, the computer will continue to not accept the input until an A or B is selected. I'll go ahead and make another example. A new program has been created, and the code used to stop the computer has already been entered into the program. For this next example, what I'd like to do is have the user enter in a number, 1 through 10, and then that number will be squared. So I'm going to need a variable. I'm going to call this variable num for our number, and num is going to be a real since we haven't used real for a while. I'm going to start the repeat loop. I'm going to write to the screen, prompting the user to enter a number, 1 through 10. Then read line the user's input into the variable num. So here we have to check to see if the number is greater than or equal to 1, which would be the low range, and the number also has to be less than or equal to 10. We can move on and I'll write line telling the user the number squared will be num multiplied by num. And since we're using a real, I'll set the alignment to 0 and we'll use 2 decimal places. Okay, everything looks pretty good. I'll go ahead and run. I'll try this out. We'll try 0, not accepted, 100, not accepted. We'll try 5.